Renan's call is made. The call is intercepted in the city's central telephone exchange by the operator. She will ask which service is required. In this case, the service required is ambulance. The call is then connected to the Humberside Ambulance Service headquarters at Springfield Way in Anlaby. The control room is a mass of telephones and computers. The phones are answered by the control assistants who take down the details. The control assistant passes the details to the controller, who then mobilises an ambulance, either by radio if the vehicle is already mobile, or by telephone if the vehicle is in base. Crew then board the vehicle and make their way to the scene. Service has an extensive fleet of vehicles located at different stations throughout the county. Not all the vehicles are emergency vehicles. The vehicles range from ambulance cars to the Sitter One vehicles designed to transport patients who are able to walk into the ambulance and sit for the journey. vehicle carries basic equipment such as blankets, vomit bowl and ambu bag. The seats fold up to facilitate storage of the blankets. The vehicle is also equipped with a radio to enable the operator to get into touch with the control. The vehicle also has a blue flashing beacon. Slightly different is the dual purpose vehicle, capable of taking sitter 1 type patients and sitter 2 type patients, manned by a 2 operator crew with a slightly higher headroom, enabling the crew to lift patients in and out of the vehicle on the carry chair. The vehicle is designed for patients who can sit for the journey. Basic equipment is the same as a sitter 1 type vehicle, with the addition of a carry chair. There we see the carry chair. The tail lift vehicle, again operated by a 2-person crew, is capable of taking patients in their own wheelchairs. Also patients who can sit for the journey. There we see the seats, which fold up to make more room for more wheelchairs. At the back you can see the tail lift, which enables the wheelchair to be lifted from floor level to the level of the ambulance. Storage space above the seats allows for storage of the ambu bag, vomit bowl, blankets and other small pieces of luggage. The vehicle is also equipped with a carrying chair. Commencement of the shift for the emergency crews requires the vehicles to be checked thoroughly, including lights and horns, as well as all the equipment inside of the vehicle. The radio is checked, the fuel levels are checked. Not only should all the equipment be there, it should also be in working order. The vehicles carry splinting equipment, a carry chair, different types of stretchers. Oxygen flow meters for delivering the oxygen to the patients. Blankets. Maternity packs. Bed pans, urine bottles. Baby resuscitation equipment. The top locker contains extrication and safety equipment. Water is carried in a flask. A monitor, defibrillator, bag and mask, pulse oximeter, vomit bowls, tissues. Cervical collars are carried in the top locker. A stretcher made up with blankets and pillow. Suction unit, which can be powered by its own battery or the vehicle's battery. Drawers containing oxygen equipment and infusion equipment, portable oxygen, the crew's cases and paramedic case. Here we see Hull Royal's Flying Squad vehicle, also known as Hull 3-1 because of its call sign. The vehicle is funded by the Hull Royal but driven by Humberside Ambulance Service ambulance personnel. It carries a floating stretcher which makes a smooth journey for the seriously ill or injured. The vehicle carries most of the ordinary ambulance equipment, as well as infusion equipment, burns dressings, and when the Hull Royal Flying Squad come out on the vehicle, they also bring with them cases containing specialised equipment. The vehicle carries pulse oximeter, suction unit, heart monitor defibrillator, Entonox, ambu bag and mask, oxygen. There we see the floating stretcher. When crews come on shift, they look at the board in the leading ambulanceman's office to see who they are crewed up with and which vehicle has been allocated to them. Here we see the vehicles parked up and ready to roll. Control room 26, priority.
26.
Yeah, Joe. The Humberside Ambulance Service has an extensive fleet of vehicles spread all over the county at different stations. Not all the vehicles, though, are emergency vehicles. Total crew. The Humberside Ambulance Service has an extensive fleet of vehicles located at different stations throughout the county. Not all the vehicles are emergency vehicles.
That's all, folks.